What complicates the issue is that they usually deny that Allah has a body. On the contrary, they usually say that they do not believe that. However, some of them say that they do not confirm whether he has a body or not, which is still blasphemy, while others might heedlessly say that he has a body, but we do not know how it is, which also does not escape blasphemy. If they deny that Allah has a body, it is because they understand that they would be clearly admitting that he is like the creation. Taking this position may be the case of most of them. Despite this denial, we know that they secretly believe that Allah has a body, because they hate for someone to say that he has no place or direction, and they think that denial of place and direction is denial of his existence. If some of them want to test your faith, they ask you, "Where is Allah?" Had it been true that testing one's faith is by asking, "Where is Allah?" then where was Allah before he created places and directions? For sure, Allah existed without places and without directions, and without the throne, the arsh, before creating anything. If they do not confirm whether Allah has a body or not, it is because they do not want to explicitly liken him to the creations, but at the same time, they do not want to reject the literal meanings that they hold to heart. This is still blasphemy, since being neutral and saying, "I do not say if Allah has a body or not," is similar to doubting about Allah, for it is lack of yaqeen, certainty, and lack of yaqeen is certainly disbelief. It is the same as saying, "I do not say if Allah exists or not," or "I do not say if Allah has a partner or not." Whoever doubts or is neutral about any attribute of Allah which is known by necessity is not a Muslim. The Salaf said so. Al-Imam Abu Hanifa, one of the heads of the real Salaf, in his book Al-Wasiyya said, "من اعتقد حدوث صفة من صفات الله أو شك أو توقف كفر." Whoever believed in the createdness of an attribute amongst the attributes of Allah, or doubted, or was neutral, has disbelieved. Doubt in the creed means having the slightest uncertainty, and neutral means not to take one side or another, yani neither to confirm nor deny either side. Compare that statement of Abu Hanifa radiallahu anhu to the verbatim statement of Ibn Uthaymeen, one of those loved by the Wahhabis. In his book Al-Liqa'u al-Shahri, he said, "Al-mutakallimu bil-lughati yatakallamu bil-lisan. أَمَّا الرَّبُّ عَزَّ وَجَلْ فَلَا يَجُوزُ أَن نُثْبِتَ لَهُ اللِّسَانَ وَلَا أَن نَنْفِيَهُ لِأَنَّهُ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا بِذَلِكَ." His statement means, "The one who speaks a language does so by a tongue. As for the Lord, عَزَّ وَجَلْ, it is not permissible for us to confirm a tongue for him, nor to deny it from him, for we have no knowledge of that." A'udhu billah. Since there is no way to take both of these quotes, which do you anticipate a Wahhabi who calls himself a Salafi would reject? Do you reckon he would disregard Abu Hanifa, an undisputed authority from the Salaf? Or disregard Ibn Uthaymeen, a contemporary small fry? Whoever considers it possible for Allah to have a body, even if he did not believe that Allah actually has one, would blaspheme for deeming it possible. The less intelligent amongst them might say the secret out loud and confess that he believes that Allah has a body, because it is obvious that that they describe a body, and he is too simple-minded to hide it. But he would then say that his body is not like ours, or that they do not know how his body is. Pay attention. As for saying that his body is not like ours, Al-Imam Abu al-Fadl al-Tamimi, the head of the Hanbalis of Baghdad, a Hanbali expert, approved even by Ibn Taymiyyah himself, said that according to the great Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, من قال الله جسم لا كالأجسام كفر, which means, whoever says that Allah is a body, unlike other bodies, blasphemes, commits kufr. In the same book, عقيدة الإمام المبجل, he also said, أنكر أحمد على من قال بالجسم وقال إن الأسماء مأخوذة من الشريعة واللغة, which means Ahmad, meaning Al-Imam Ahmad, objected to those who attribute a body to Allah, and he said, indeed, the names of things are taken from the sacred law and the language. He continued to say, وأهل اللغة وضعوا هذا الاسم على ذي طول وعرض وسمك وتركيب وصورة وتأليف والله سبحانه وتعالى خارج عن ذلك كله. He said, as for the language, the linguists applied this name, jism, which means body, to that which has length, width, depth, construction, image, and composition. And Allah, the glorified and exalted, is beyond that entirely, meaning he's not attributed with any of that. He continued to say, وَلَمْ يَجِئْ ذَٰلِكَ فِي الشَّرِيعَةِ فَبَطَلْ, and that did not come used for God in the sacred law, so it is invalid. Saying we do not know how his body is blasphemy. The scholars of Islam have made it evidently clear that besides the fact that Allah is not a body, kayf, how, cannot be attributed to him. Throughout the books of the Sunni scholars, you would find that they said about Allah and his attributes, bila kayf, which means without a how, without a manner of being. This means that Allah does not have a manner of being, or a way, or a mode, or a how about him. He does not have any created descriptions. He does not have color, shape, form, dimensions, or any physical qualities. Thus, to say they do not know how he is to say there is a how, but it is unknown to them. Saying that the how of his body, in their claim, is unknown, does not negate the fact that they believe he has a body. Just as saying, the door is open, but I do not know how, does not negate the fact that the door is open. Likewise, they say, we don't know how he sits, or how he descends, or how his hands are, or how his eyes are. أعوذ بالله. What this truly means is, they do not know if he is sitting Indian style, or like the one who sits in the prayer, and they do not know if he ascends head first or feet first, or like a belly flop or a cannonball, أعوذ بالله, or if he has a human hand or a monkey hand, or an eye on the chin or on the forehead, etc. Do you see how ridiculous this sounds to the sound mind? This is what the Wahhabis are saying. The Wahhabis do not deny any of this because they believe Allah has a how, but they say we don't know which how it is. So if one of them says, we do not know how, tell him that the scholars of the real Salaf have agreed that there is no how, which is a categoric negation of any mode or fashion or manner of being, as narrated from the likes of Umm Salama, the Prophet's wife, radiyallahu anha. She said, وَالْكَيْفُ غَيْرُ مَعْقُولِ, which means the how being attributed to him is not rational, meaning it does not make sense that how would be attributed to Allah, the one who created everything that has a how. Similar to that was reported about Malik and Rabi'ah ibn Abd al-Rahman. If Allah willed, this point will be revisited in the section The Truth About Al-Istiwa. These people may have never learned the correct belief. So when they learned their incorrect belief and became attached to it, they developed a warped reasoning. Their thinking is based on an unsound premise that Allah is attributed with these human attributes. They also have other horrendous and contradictory claims, which will not be mentioned now. As a result, their thinking became twisted, like the Christians who say that Allah is one and is three while He is one. The Wahhabis believe that Allah has these human attributes, such as motion, organs, places, and directions. Yet they claim that they believe that Allah is not similar to His creations. This is clearly unsound and incorrect. We ask Allah Ta'ala to increase us in the authentic Islamic knowledge and to keep us steadfast and firm upon it. Allahumma ameen. And we ask Allah to grant us the good end. Ameen. And Allah knows best.